Recently, image generation models have been emerging one after another. Today, the model we are introducing to everyone is called Z-Image. It comes from Alibaba. I personally feel that this is a great model. Why do I say this? We can take a look at its official website. Within the description on the website, we can see a few key terms. The first one is 6B6. B stands for 6 billion parameters. How many parameters does Flux have? 32 billion. So you will notice that this is definitely a lightweight model. Furthermore, there is another key phrase here, 1 second, meaning it can generate an image in 1 second. There's also another keyword called 16G, which refers to RAM consumption. In addition to this, it has many other features, such as extremely efficient photo-level realism. We can observe from the official examples displayed that indeed its photorealistic capability is particularly outstanding. This applies not only to figures, but also to scenery and still life, where the overall performance is quite good. Moreover, it features excellent rendering capabilities in both Chinese and English. This means it can accurately write text onto the image. There are also examples below that you can view, and the results are very stunning. It also has other abilities listed below, but these are outside the scope of our discussion today. The reason is that this model is actually a suite, not a single model. The model we are focusing on today is called Z-Image Turbo. There will also be an edit version later, which is very similar to QWImage and QWImage Edit. Currently, we can already use this model within ComfyUI. You can open the official ComfyUI website. If we look further down in the example section, we will find one labeled Z-Image. If you click on it, we can see a very detailed example page. On this page, you will notice that we still need to download the text encoder, the main model, and the VAE. These are the three components of the model. Its text encoder uses the QWIN34B model, and the VAE is generally common with Flux 1. So, generally speaking, we only need to download these two. Most people should have already downloaded them. There is also a workflow here. You can drag this workflow into your ComfyUI and start using it. However, an important prerequisite is that ComfyUI must be updated to the latest version. I have also built a workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform via Running Hub. In the ComfyUI field, Running Hub is an excellent online workflow platform because it immediately follows up whenever new technology or new models appear. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description area, which will give you 1,000 free points. Additionally, logging into Running Hub Daily will give you 100 free credits, allowing you to experiment with your own workflows. When we drag this image into ComfyUI, you will roughly see something like this. First, the main model is Z-Image Turbo BF16. Then, our text encoder is QW4B, followed by the Flux VAA model. The latent image is still generated using the MTST3 latent image node. The sampler itself is nothing particularly special. We used 9 steps for sampling, and the CFG is 1.0. After decoding, you can get an image. Take a look. This image fully illustrates the realism. We can enlarge it. The sense of realism is very strong. This includes the texture of the skin, the overall construction of light and shadow, and the state of the figure. Through this example, you can likely see that this model's capability in generating photorealism is extremely strong. Secondly, its generation speed is very fast. Let's run it. Take a look. This took us about 57 seconds. However, this time includes the model loading time. Let's run it again. This time the model doesn't need to load. It starts sampling directly. Let's see how fast the sampling speed is. We see it took 23 seconds. Actually, this still includes the time to display the image. Of course, this speed is related to many factors. Note that the resolution I am currently using is very high, 1280 by 1920. So generating such a high-resolution image is enough to demonstrate how fast this model is. From this, we can also see that it can directly output high-resolution images. Regarding its realism, I have performed many tests for you. Take a look, there are various figures in various scenes, both male and female. Moreover, you will also notice that across all these images, the figures do not look alike. This is because many models, although they have sufficient realism, produce characters that look very similar. This model, however, definitely does not have this problem. Now, let's use these few images to demonstrate its realism. First, take a look. This is an oriental figure, a beautiful woman wearing hanfu, who is very attractive. Notice all the details, they are very well executed. Let's look at a western figure. The overall performance is also excellent. Which image should we focus on? Let's look at this one. Pay attention, this image is very interesting. Notice that it is a selfie, specifically a selfie generated by photographing oneself in the mirror. You will find that the rendering of the entire image is truly outstanding. Furthermore, it can almost reflect people's habits when taking photos. This is because we all know that when trying on clothes, we might try to avoid showing our face. So, it perfectly resembles a girl trying on an outfit and taking a picture. Now, let's look at this image. I previously generated this image once using Nano Banana Pro. That effect looked especially like a cartoon, and the figure resembled an animated character. The depiction of the dragon and the state of the water were not particularly good either, but look at the effect generated by Z image. First, let's look at the state of the figure. It is photorealistic, which is correct. Then, look at the state of the dragon. It conforms exactly to the expression of Chinese elements. Look at the feeling of the water and fire intertwined. It is also very accurate. I even turned it into a video. Feel this for a moment. The overall quality and dynamism of this video are astonishing. Notice the water, the fire dragon, and the background. They all have corresponding dynamic effects. The character's movements are also very smooth. Now, let's talk about precise control. Let's look at this section. We wanted to generate the trajectory decomposition of a horizontal projectile motion. Then we run it. Look at the final generated effect. We can see that its representation of the formula and the overall sense are decent. Although the effect generated by this model cannot be directly compared with Nano Banana, overall, we find that its ability to control generation is very strong. Since it only has 6 billion parameters, achieving such a precise generation effect is already very astonishing. Next, let's talk about a topic. What is the relationship between Z image and Qdoublin image? Take a look. This is a Qdoublin image workflow. I have input data in JSON format here. Both Qdoublin image and Z image support JSON format data. Let's look at the effect after generation. First, the overall image generation is fine. However, the facial diversity of Qdoublin image is relatively poor. We can see that the beautiful women look like this. Then, let's run it again. You can see that they look basically the same. Now, let's look at Z image. The two prompts are exactly the same. Then, let's look at the effect of the girl it generated. Everyone see it looks like this. Now, let's generate it again. You can see that the similarity is not that high. This is one point. However, the key aspect we want to demonstrate is not this level. Look, there's a lot of text on this. There was no corresponding text appearing on Qdoubly image. What is the reason? It is because I used a JSON format prompt here. JSON format prompts contain many double quotes. Both Qdoubly image and Z image are quite sensitive to double quotes. Generally, if double quotes are included, it is considered text. Although both models are sensitive to double quotes, the degree of sensitivity is different. Qdoublin image is slightly less sensitive. However, similar situations can still occur, for instance. Let's look at this example. This is a Chinese prompt. You don't need to worry about what it means. We used many double quotes within it. Now let's look at the generated result. Besides the text I wanted to write, it also inserted the content from one of the double quotes. The situation is even more particular with Z image. Since there are many double quotes here, you will find that a lot of text appears. This is not an isolated case. Look at this one. There's also a lot of text appearing here. This is all because we have many double quotes in the prompt. So how do we solve this? We can clearly know now that both models perform very well with JSON format prompts. Look at the generated effect. The only issue is that Z image is too sensitive to double quotes. We suggest that you replace the double quotes with single quotes. Let's try it. Okay, now let's look at the generated image. The text has disappeared. Of course, there is an extra hand here, but that is not our primary focus. Look, I still have a JSON format prompt, but I replaced the double quotes with single quotes. This condition will greatly reduce the chances of text appearing, but you should note that it cannot completely eliminate the issue, but the situation will be much better. Therefore, when using Zimage, if you want to generate images using JSON format prompts, remember to make this adjustment, because it is undeniable that the quality of images generated using JSON format prompts is very high. Let's try drawing another card. This one doesn't have the extra hand issue. It is a very beautiful image. So, let's summarize Zimage. Let's summarize image. It is fast, the parameter count is small, and the generation quality is high. It supports high resolution and supports JSON format prompts. Considering all these advantages, you will find that this model is enough for our daily use. We definitely won't use large models like Flux 2, even though its capabilities might be much stronger. But the speed is too slow, right? Therefore, I strongly recommend this model to everyone. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me and become someone who understands AI.